Okay, so here's a question I keep seeing in the comments. Is it possible to fake the anamorphic look with all its characteristics like distortion, field of view, flares and bokeh by using a normal spherical lens and then just crop top and bottom, and by adding some effects in DaVinci Resolve to really emulate those anamorphic characteristics? And that's a great question. Right up my alley, op mijn lijf geschreven. That's how we say it in Dutch. It's written on my body. Yeah. Anyway, so the first thing I want to do is show you what a cropped spherical lens looks like compared to a real anamorphic lens, without adding any effects or editing in DaVinci Resolve, so that we know what we're working with. And the first thing you need to know is how field of view works with anamorphic lenses. Because, for example, this 35mm anamorphic lens has a vertical field of view of 35mm, but the horizontal field of view is wider because an anamorphic lens squeezes the image onto the sensor. And so, horizontally, when you unsqueeze it, this one is actually the equivalent of 21mm. And that's one of the main characteristics of an anamorphic lens. And same goes for this 75mm. Vertically, it's 75mm, but horizontally, the field of view is wider. This one is around 47mm. And how much wider it is depends on the squeeze factor, so it's not the same for every anamorphic lens. But anyway, what I want to say is that technically, a shot with a normal spherical lens set at 21mm and then cropped in post should look almost identical to a shot with this 35mm anamorphic, right? But let me just show you, it'll be easier to understand. So here's a shot with my 35mm anamorphic. And here's the same shot with a normal spherical lens at 21mm, cropped. And in DaVinci Resolve, it's super easy to do, by the way. There's also different ways to do it. I usually do it like this, adjustment clip on top of my video, crop it here in the inspector, and then this way I can still move my shot up and down, see, to improve composition or whatever. But what do you think? I mean, composition, perspective, field of view-wise, it looks pretty similar, right? Almost identical. And that's of course because I didn't have to move the camera. The camera was in exactly the same position for both shots because I used that 21mm to match the anamorphic lens's wider field of view. Here's a few other shots to compare. This is 35mm anamorphic, and this is 21mm normal spherical lens. So when it comes to composition and field of view and perspective, it's pretty similar, right? Almost identical. But of course, there's more to the anamorphic look, and that's where DaVinci Resolve comes in. Most anamorphic lenses have distortion, and the distortion mostly affects horizontal lines, and it's most noticeable more towards the edges of the frame. Now, this is something we can easily recreate in DaVinci Resolve, even though it's not so easy to get exactly the same result as, you know, as a real anamorphic lens. But anyway, so one technique you can use is with the barrel distortion effect here in the color page, or even better, the warper effect, which gives you more control. So set this on manual, and then when you start clicking, you're setting warp points. And if you hold shift and click, then you add red points. And you can use those red points to tell Resolve that you don't want that area to be affected by the warper effect. And then just play around with the amount of distortion. And then when we go back to the edit page and add a mask for the correct aspect ratio, it looks like anamorphic distortion. But I must say that warper effect is difficult, so practice a lot. Now, something that's absolutely not difficult is finding great music with Audio, the sponsor of this video. I use Audio for all my videos, travel videos, cinematic sequences, but also for background music in videos like this. But you know what? I'll link some videos in the description because it's music and you should hear and feel it, right? So go check it out. And they also have this cool new feature called Link Match AI. All you need to do is copy a link to a video with music or a song on Spotify, and Link Match AI will find the closest match in Audio's entire library. It will save you so much time. But of course, you can also still browse for hours through playlists and play around with all the filters. So go check them out. An Audio Pro subscription is 70% off. Just use my link and code in the description. And as always, thank you so much, Audio, for supporting my channel. And now back to the anamorphic look in DaVinci Resolve. Anamorphic lenses usually also have that typical sharpness fall off. Again, mostly towards the edges of the frame, left and right, but sometimes also top and bottom. So just go to the color page and then go to effects, pick a blur effect you like. Let me exaggerate it a little bit now. There, and then just go to mask here, click on the circle mask, and then this icon to invert the mask. And see, now only the areas outside the circle are affected by the blur effect. And then of course you can resize it, make the transition softer, and of course make sure that there's not too much blur. It has to be subtle, something like that. Just find a nice balance and transition from in focus to out of focus. It shouldn't be too abrupt. And then there are flares, of course. Sometimes blue, sometimes more neutral in color, but those wide horizontal flares are one of the most typical characteristics of anamorphic lenses. Now, this is where it gets a bit trickier if you want to fake it. Well, actually, there's an easy way, and that's using a flare filter. I tried one a long time ago, and I mean, it works, but in my opinion, it creates way too much flares. Flares all over the place. It's like it puts a flare on every light source in the frame. So, in my opinion, a bit too much. But you can also do it in DaVinci Resolve, and then you have more control, and you can be a bit more creative even. So, in the color page, go to Effects, look for the flare effect, and then you can pick one of the presets, play around with the settings and the color until you have your perfect flare. And then if it's a moving shot, go to Tracker here, set it to Effects Tracker, then hit this little arrow here, put the cross or plus sign on whatever object you want to track, and hit Track. And see, now the flare follows that object. But you can still reposition it if you'd like. So, it might not be a real optical flare, but you have more control over what your flare looks like, you know? And then, the most difficult part, the bokeh, the out-of-focus backgrounds, depth of field. First, the amount of blur. Remember that I used a 21mm spherical lens to get the same horizontal field of view as the 35mm anamorphic? Well, because of that wider focal length, the background will naturally be less blurry at the same aperture. Because focal length affects depth of field. So, if you want the same amount of blur, you'll have to widen your aperture, if you can. But the real difficult part is the shape of the bokeh. Because the anamorphic out-of-focus backgrounds are oval and elongated. You can use adapters for this, that's easy. Just buy one of those oval-shaped adapters. Or you can try to do it in DaVinci Resolve. But depending on your shot, it's gonna be a lot of work. And I'm gonna be honest here, it will never look perfect. Because what you have to do is, well, again, there are different ways to do it. What you could do is copy your clip and then go to the color page, use Magic Mask to remove the background of that top clip, then go back and then select the bottom clip, and then add a lens blur effect to that bottom clip. Play around with the settings so that you get that oval, elongated, stretched background blur effect. And then it's just a matter of tweaking your mask so that you get the least amount of imperfections. But like I said, it's almost impossible to get it perfect. If not impossible. Okay, so conclusion. Yeah, sure, you can fake the anamorphic look to some extent. It's a lot of work. But it's possible, but always remember that you're trying to replicate an optical effect digitally, so it will never look exactly the same. It will always be a generic, shallow copy of an anamorphic look. You know what I mean? It looks anamorphic, but not really. And also, when filmmakers go for a specific type or brand of anamorphic lenses, it's not just because of the anamorphic look, it's because of the characteristics of that specific type or brand of lenses. And so yeah, if that's important to you, just buy an anamorphic lens. There's no way to copy that or replicate it. So yeah, okay, there you go. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.